Hello everybody, Tempest is here, and today we will be starting new let's play on our new map called Sosnovka. Here is the deal, ladies and gentlemen. Our uncle Vasily recently passed away, and in his will he left me his farm, and now I'm heading there from Moscow to check it out. I sold my apartment and I've spent a little bit while I was getting here. So as you can see, I have 87,982 euros to set up everything, whatever he did not set up for us, and maybe just see what's missing and stuff. Now I must continue his great work. But before we do that, I just want to quickly check out what is available to us, how well everything is prepared. Alrighty, there we go. This is the farm. I just want to park decently somewhere. Maybe we can find parking spot over here. It should be fine. Alright, it's great. Now let's stop the engine. Yes, this is my car. I'm planning to sell it. I don't think we'll be needing it in the nearest future. So this is the farm I must develop now. Alright, don't run me over, please. Okay, first thing I see is our gas here, our truck that supposedly should help us transport our grain and stuff. Alright, looks great. Looks super awesome. Although a bit outdated. I don't know how much it's gonna cost me in maintenance. Alright, this is the Zetter available to us, which is looking great. It's looking great. Nothing special though. It's around 120 horsepower. Ooh, that tractor over there is amazing. Let's check it out. Yeah, this is the fertilizer refilling spot, and this is our sprayer, which should be some sort of an outdated vehicle as well. Let's check it out from the inside. Yeah, it looks great. It looks awesome. I think we can work with that. There is another tractor that should help us mow our fields, and it looks awesome too. Alright, although I don't know how much it's going to cost me in maintenance, I think it should be pretty expensive, and we have to prepare to pay a lot for that. I see that this farm is very well prepared, and I think that it shouldn't be a problem for us to set everything up. And ooh, there is even another tractor that is on maintenance at the moment. I think something is broken. We need to fix it. Alright, looks like it's a Belarus tractor, and we can check it out from inside and check if it's up and running. Alright, I will start the engine and see if it's working or not. Ooh, nice sound. Everything is working so far. I'm enjoying how everything is set up. Okay, here is our mower and the tedder. Nothing too crazy. Everything is set up for the initial start, I think, but we have to work very hard in order to develop this farm. So we have a clear picture of what is available to us to start with, and I'm not very much disappointed, I should say. What I want to do now, ooh, there is even some sort of a weight available to us. I think this one is 1700 kgs. It's very, very, very heavy, and I don't even know what tractor is going to be suitable for that. This one is 1000 kgs weight. Decent. I'm loving what I see. Ooh, look at that. This tractor is insane. Is it from 1920s? I think so. I think it is going to cost us bazillion dollars to maintain it. But I like it. I like the way it looks, and I think we can find some sort of a use for that, even for the plow, which is super duper short, but we can use it. Let's start the engine and hear how well it sounds. All right. Oh my gosh. So those are supposed to be our controls to turn right. Oh, this is too loud. Stop the, I don't know if I'm gonna use this tractor, but it looks insane. I think it's gonna work very well with the equipment, which is super duper small too. I think it's gonna work very well. So yeah, this episode, ladies and gentlemen, I just wanna set everything up. Just wanna see how well everything is working. And yeah, we've got cows. Our poor cows have nothing to eat. They eat dust and, well, nothing else. Alright, we gotta work on that. I know that Uncle Vasily had 35 cows and around 30 sheep. So we should make sure. Ooh, look at that. We even have modern equipment in here. Yes, something to look forward to. We have the JCB skidster. I want to check out the forestry area and just see what is available to us over there. I know that Uncle Vasily had a couple of trucks there as well, which he asked me to take care of. I don't know what I want to do first on this farm, but initial impressions is that it is super duper expensive to maintain, so I hope that I can do that. I hope I can deal with that without going into debt. Yeah, for that we need to start doing something. In this episode, I think I will start with sowing, with cultivating, and preparing my fields. By the way, I want to quickly check on what kind of fields there were. So, we have fields number 14, 19, 23, 25, and 28. Well, nothing outrageous. We should be finding our way around it. I think we will turn field number 28 into our grass field. That should help us a lot with feeding our cows and sheep. Alright, this is the forest area. Somewhere around we should find additional equipment, additional machinery. Ooh, there we go. Interesting. Alright, I see our Ural here. It looks like it's in great condition. Welcome, buddy. Welcome to our farm. And there is something else. There is Komatsu. Komatsu woodcutter. Looks awesome. Let's take a look at it from the outside. I think we can work with it. Thankfully, we have the woodcutter and it looks great. It looks like, look at that! Another outdated, very, very old equipment. Looks like it's some sort of a wheel loader, but it looks incredible. It looks super duper old and I hope that we can work with it somehow. Alright, let's start the engine. Listen to how well it works. Even if it's gonna start or not. Yes, it starts. It starts. It should work. I think that, but it's so rusty. Header itself. Looks like it's gonna work fine. Alright, this is the way you pick up your logs. And we will be loading it up into our Ural. Yeah, I think that there is no need to sell all this outdated equipment. Because we will find use for that. If not, we will always be able to sell it a bit later. Yeah, so far so good. I'm loving what I see on this farm. I think we can deal with that. So without further ado, let's just quickly start our farm management process. Alright, I wanna get to my farm first of all. I think I wanna start with the harvesting. As I know, we have quite a modern harvester there as well. 9 meters wide. And we should be good to go. Thankfully, I didn't have to pay a lot for this farm. It's been very well prepared for us to work on. And yeah, I think it's a great farm. It's a great farm in general. I think we can make it work. We can develop it even further. And yeah, we gotta set our first goals and head towards our goals. That would be great to do. Here is the bale selling point. That's great. I will stop my vehicle here. And there is the mixer, also available to us. So far, so good. I'm loving what I see, but first things first, let's go ahead and start our harvesting process, as we have field number 19 already sowed and ready to be harvested, thanks to Uncle Vasily. He's been very good. Sadly, he just passed recently, so we gotta take over his amazing farm. And I think he's been working his whole life on it. He worked a lot. He earned his money. And I think he owes a little bit to the bank, but nothing crucial. So this farm comes with the loan of... What is the loan? I think we need to go to the shop to find that out. But I know there is some sort of a loan and we gotta deal with it. We gotta work our arses off to be able to pay it off. Alright, looks like our harvester is a decent one. Alright, it works great. Works better than I expected. Next thing I wanna do is I wanna check on my other equipment. There we go, there is the DT70, I think that's the name of this amazing tractor. And prepare your ears, ladies and gentlemen, we will be starting this harvester. Damn it, this tractor up. Oh my gosh. Yeah, actually, what I want to do is I want to start sowing the wheat. That's the basic thing I want to do. I want to test the structure out, if it's even useful. Maybe it's not useful at all and we will have to sell it. Just let's go ahead and do that. Alright, there is our field number 14. And we will start our sowing process right away. No, don't use the lights. Alright, it's great. It's great. Alright, so far I'm enjoying controlling this dinosaur tractor, and it's so freaking loud. I don't know how loud it is for you guys, but let's see how it's gonna work. Maybe it's gonna work just great. All right, and again, I'm gonna be hiring a worker for that. Just don't wanna be working with it too much because it's too loud. Let's just take a look at it from the outside and just make sure that everything is gonna work and how well everything is gonna work. All right, it's gonna work fine. It's gonna work decent. Our DT70 is gonna work, and let our friend Bob deal with that. Yes, he came with us to work on this farm as well. Okay, what next? So exciting. Let's check upon our harvester here. Working great. We have the trail of straw left in there. I think I will collect it for cows straight away. But before we do that, I want to quickly set my fertilization process. By the way, yes, this is our fertilization vehicle. It should help us fertilize our fields, and the width is around 14 meters, which is great, decent. All right, this is our gaz, our vehicle that is responsible for transporting grain. I know that vehicles on this farm mostly are outdated versions of what is available nowadays, but that's all Uncle Vasily had, so I cannot complain. I gotta do best out of it, and maybe in the future we can afford something more modern, I should say. And I think that I will try to purchase the Russian or the Soviet equipment mostly in the future. Maybe if I don't find anything suitable, then we can work with the other brands. These trailers are not capable of transporting our grain. I should have guessed it. All right, now that our trailers are attached, we can go ahead and unload our harvester, which is full, I think, and waiting for our truck here. All right, harvester is full. Not really, almost full. I want to approach it from the left side and then unload it. Should be great. All right, this harvester, even though it's not the best, it looks like a new one, and it should serve us for a long, long time without any doubts. Left, there we go. Finally, we started unloading our body here. It should be good. We can see great yield already. Come on. Alrighty. It's great. It looks great. It works just fine. First 4,500 liters are in our truck already. Now the second. Alright, here we go. I wonder how well Chorus Play is gonna handle it a bit later. How well Chorus Play is gonna handle both trailers, but for now should be good enough, I guess. Alright, 8,100 liters in the bank, and now we gotta go and unload everything. Please select the trailer inside the trigger for tipping. Alright, this is the way it works. We gotta unload each and every trailer individually, I guess. Not the left. Let's use the back side. There we go, and now the back side works just fine. I think I shouldn't use the back side. I will try to use the left side or even the right side, because it's gonna work better in the future. Alright, but for now, what I wanna do is I wanna check upon the sowing process and just watch my harvester, the way it harvests the field, so that I could be able to unload it whenever is needed. Alright, there is another tractor which we don't use so far, but here are our dollies relaxing, having fun. Have nothing to eat, although they have grass whatsoever. And yeah, what I wanna do next is the next episode, I think I will do a bit of logging just to test the new woodcutter as well as the new loader here. Hopefully they're gonna work well. Okay, it looks like DT70 here works great for us, at least on the smaller fields. It's gonna be useful, so I'm not planning on selling it just yet. Yes, it's super slow, 9 kilometers per hour, but it's doing its job just fine. These fields will handle it just fine. All right the next thing I want to do is I want to check if this tractor will even work. Let's start the engine and try to, although you know what I want to do is actually I wanna start sowing other fields, and for that, let's stop the engine of this truck. For that, we will be using this Belarus tractor. It's been repaired, I guess. Works just fine. Let's proceed. There we go. There we go. Okay, first things first. Let's attach our sewing machine to this beast of a tractor. I think it's around 320 horsepower. And it's great. It's gonna serve us very, very, very well. And first thing I wanna do is I wanna attach the weight. Let's check the hood of this beast. It's great. I can see the engine in there. The radiator works just fine. Where is the sewing machine? There we go, there is our sewing machine. And I think I will start preparing the grass field. No, actually I'm gonna do the grass field in the next episode. For now, I just wanna start sewing the field number. 23. Sewing is going great. Next thing I wanna do is I wanna unload this harvester as it's done with our field number 19. What else? Alrighty, I'm so freaking lost. Yeah, what I wanted to do actually, completely forgot it, but now I remember. So I wanted to attach my forage wagon to this tractor and start harvesting straw for our cows. At least 10% productivity. It won't hurt us. It will benefit us the most. And let's just do that. This tractor is super duper slow. It costs us a lot of money per day to maintain, but for now it's our best bet. We don't have anything better than that. Of course, we have a couple more powerful tractors. I cannot afford to sell this one just yet. Let's just deal with that. We will attach our forage wagon. There we go. Take a look at our DT70. works like a beast. Works like a beast. Come on, buddy. You can do that. You can finish sowing this field. You can. So yeah, I think I will keep that tractor. Even though it's super duper loud, super duper slow, it will handle smaller kind of fields very well. I think field number 14 and field number 19 are gonna be on him. Now, we are ready to do our forage wagon process. And before I do that, I wanna unload my harvester with the truck. Where is it? There we go. Our truck is ready to unload the harvester. Let's go ahead and proceed to the field. And that's it, I guess. We have harvested our only field that's been available to us. Oh my gosh, come on. Come on. Come on, I'm missing it completely. Gotta park a bit farther than that. Gotta remember that. Finally, I managed to adjust it just fine. And we have, what, 2,400? There we go, 1,000 left. I think the first one is gonna be full. Yep, it's full, only 500 liters left. Let's load it in here. Alright, it's great. Our farm, I mean, oh, actually, you know what? We missed a bit of wheat in there. I want to quickly harvest it. And take a look at this location. It's so beautiful. I'm loving what I see. I think we're going to have lots of fun times while working on this farm. And I think I like the wheel, to be honest. It looks very well with the knob on it. Lower the pickup and turn on the forage wagon. We will load everything up here. We just need a bit of straw for our cows to eat at least something. Of course, the productivity won't be the best, but it's better than nothing. So yeah, the next thing we need to think about is, of course, grass. Grass is going to be very vital in our farm's life because we have, what, we have 30 cows and we have 30 sheep. It's going to be great if we manage to keep them happy and well fed. And it looks like DT70 has done its job very well. Not complaining at all. Yeah, so I can see I found myself very well on this farm. I'm enjoying it. I think Uncle Vasily would have been very, very, very proud of me just to see how well I managed to set everything up. My first day on this farm on Sosnovka, and we're doing just fine. Things are looking up, things are looking very, very good. And in the future, I think the next thing I need to do is actually sell my car. I won't be needing it anymore, because this is my home now. I won't be needing to travel anywhere else. Let's go ahead and unload our straw. So there we go, dollies. Now you have something to eat. Be happy about it and enjoy. Alright, it's great, it's great. We have a bunch of straw in here. And dollies have something to eat. So yeah, the first day has been very productive already. I want to just make sure that our sowing process is going well. that our DT70 isn't broken already and it's still working. By the way, take a look at that. Our 30 cows consume almost full trailer of straw in here. So that's something to think about. Maybe we need to upgrade it very soon. It's done a great job in here. Of course, the next goal for it would be to solve field number 19. But that's exactly what we're going to be doing in the next episode. In the next episode, oh yeah, it takes a while for the engine to heat up, I guess. It won't go. Okay, I'm enjoying this tractor the most so far. I'll be honest, take a look at the handles here. That's the way you control your tractor, just like a tank. Yes, to the right and to the left. I'm loving it. Although it is the oldest thing in the world, I'm still enjoying it. Hope it won't just fall apart in the future. There we go. Now our DT70 is ready for sowing field number 19. That's gonna happen in the next episode. And yeah, we are seeing our field number 23 sowed. And for now, I think that's gonna be it. We now know what we have to work with in the future. Let me know in the comments below, ladies and gentlemen, what we think, what you think about this let's play. Let's play, I mean. If you have any great mods for this farm, I'd appreciate that. It took me almost 2 days to find appropriate mods with the new patch that are actually working. Especially tractors are very hard to find. I'm loving what I see so far. So thank you for watching this one, ladies and gentlemen. Let me know in the comments below. Let me know in the comments below your thoughts. And as usual, live like there's no tomorrow. Bye bye. Turn back, time do it over again. Just turn back.